from the campus of Nashville Christian. This is Mike McPherson along with Chandler Clark bringing you semifinal state action as Nashville Christian is hosting Jackson Christian. And we know this, Chandler, the Eagles are going to win tonight. Both teams are nicknamed the Eagles, and we're in the semifinals.
That's right, Mike. Have an identity crisis here, a mascot versus itself. So,
yes.
But we're hoping it's our hometown Nashville Christian Eagles who will be making their way to Chattanooga after the game is over for a state title bout, perhaps.
Well, we've got a field cam as Mr. Atkins, who's our producer, is down on the field, so we'll have some different shots. We're excited about that. Let's look at the two-team season so far. And Jackson Christian opened with the game against North Point Christian, winning 24-17, defeated St. George 35-26, Evangelical 56-7, Harding Academy 63-0. Then they lost to University School of Jackson 59-17. Back to beat Tipton Rosemark 55-7, FACS 49-3, beat Trinity 49-42, and that's our common opponent. And they probably don't want to look at the score to that one for us.
Mm-mm.
Fayette Academy 55-14. Columbia Academy 49-14, winning in the quarterfinals 27-25. We're going to go to our prayer on the field at this time. Stirring rendition of our national anthem as our team gathers at the far end to run onto the field. Chandler, it's do or die tonight.
It's a big one. It'll be the final game at Keaton Field this season for these seniors. So I know emotions are high. Coach King today has been nervous all day, but probably hopefully more anxious than nervous. You know, he said hopefully the guys fuel off of that. That excitement.
All right. Well, the Eagles are in mass to rush at the far end with the cheerleaders holding up the banner. It's a cold one here and our temperature is dipping now around 30, and it'll be below that by the end of the game. So it's a frosty one. Jackson Christian has brought a contingent of fans from West Tennessee up, and they're hoping they can continue their streak of victories here. Nashville Christian opened with two losses against Franklin Road and Good Pasture, then defeated BGA, Clarksville Academy, Davidson Academy, one of the greatest games ever on this field, 59-51. Grace Christian, 36-0. Clarksville Northwest, 49-19. Columbia Academy, 31-14. Mount Juliet, 43-12. DCA, 42-7. And our common opponent, Trinity Christian. And here come the Eagles onto the field. It's football time in Bellevue.
There's the Rockets' red glare right there, Mike, just across midfield.
Yes, and the bomb's bursting in air.
That's right.
So Chandler, Nashville Christian will be kicking off, and who do we need to key on tonight with this fine group from Jackson?
They are bringing over a workhorse, number 3, Cameron Boyd. We expect to say his name quite a lot tonight. He's not the tallest in stature, but he makes up for it in speed and power. He's got 20-plus touchdowns on the season. The Eagles did a great job a couple weeks ago, the final regular season game, stifling DCA's great running back as well. And so they're going to need to do something similar tonight if they're going to pick up a win.
We're just about ready for the kickoff as Wyatt Martin is going to tee it up. And he's done a fine job all year long, the junior. And we'll check the numbers for Jackson Christian getting back deep. And I'm assuming Boyd will not be one of those, risking an injury. Don't leave action ever. Wyatt Martin to tee it up at the 40. And it's a brisk one here in Bellevue. And the weather is right now not coming up on my phone. So
I think we're 20s territory, 30s.
I know it's cold, but it feels great in this booth. So I know those of you watching this game are watching it delayed. We are not live streaming tonight. Of course, you don't know that right now. Or you didn't know that when I said that. You do now. And you already know who won. So if we could do a little time warp, space continuum, back to the future there, you already know and we don't. So I'm not sure what the delay is. I guess waiting till exactly 7 o'clock, the officials.
I know they're looking at the scoreboard here. We got.
They are.
We got zeros on the clock. I think they're waiting for the clock to get set and ready. There we go. And there's 12 minutes.
All right.
Oh, and it's winding.
It's not supposed to do that. So the clock has already started. So we've got a little bit of a malfunction for some reason, and it's still ticking.
And, yeah.
Coach Brothers is now pointing that out to the officials, and the officials are pointing that out to the booth. So we will have another delay. Semifinal action. The winner will play in the state championship 2 weeks from
yesterday.
A week after Thanksgiving.
Against the winner of USJ versus Friendship Christian, which is happening right now as well.
We'll try to give you updates on that, hopefully. We've got a good crowd here for a cold, frosty night, coldest one of the year, and this game is underway. A short pooch kick. It will be fielded by Vaughn on a fair catch, and Nashville Christian will go on defense to begin the game. On that front line will be Bradley and Potts at tackles, Santos and Woodard at your ends. JT Robbins and Cam Carden, your linebackers. Corners, Donovan Smith, Braylon Toll, and safeties, Bryson Holt, James Warmbrode, and Lawson Andrews will also be coming in there. The ball goes to their man, Boyd, and he's not going to get anything met by the left side of that line. And I saw in there JT Robbins hitting And also Bryson Holt, freshman, coming up from his safety spot.
Whew, huge pop there. They're setting the tone early.
Second down and eight. Nashville Christian would be considered favorites, but it's playoff time and you never know. And here's the ball given off on a little counter inside handoff going the other way to number 23, Jalen Mosley, and he's going to be tripped up, but he gets a short gain, so it's a manageable third down and six. On a cold, frosty one here. Really the first time we've had inclement weather this year, Chandler.
That's right. This will be a unique test for our home team here.
Jackson Christian, they've got the quarterback Kelly, and he's going to throw a pass. It is incomplete, deflected by Donovan Smith at the last second before the intended receiver, Jalen Mosley, could get a hand on it. And the ball will be punted by Jackson Christian.
That was a nice job there. We were a little fortunate. I think Kelly got the ball out and to the receiver before he got his head turned around. But Donovan heads up play there to knock it away to bring up the punting unit.
We've got Smith back along with Jaden Satterfield. And here's the punt. We almost got it. I don't know how we didn't. Ball is going to be filled by Satterfield, 35-40, and knocked out of bounds. Excuse me, that was Warmbrode. I apologize. Almost blocking the kick.
It was a Blair Otero.
That was Blair Otero. And he avoided, fortunately, roughing the kicker. I don't know how the punter got it off. But it'll be first and 10, and we have a good field position out at the 42-yard line as Nashville Christian brings Jared Curtis onto the field. And at front line, Nate Thompson at center, Peyton Woodard and Kevin Bradley your guards. Tackles, Brendan Rainey and Devin Ray. We'll set the rest of them as we've got pistol formation. Here's Curtis. A little wide out swing over here to Cam Carden, and he's going to be hit behind the line of scrimmage, then keeps turning and spinning and churning for 7, maybe 8 yards. What an incredible run where he was met behind the line of scrimmage by 2 yards, and on his own, Chandler spins and turns and twists.
Yeah,
for a big pickup.
We've seen Cam break long touchdown receptions after a little screen pattern here, so I like that we're involving that in the passing game. I'm sure Jackson Christian knows that Jared Curtis is not afraid to chuck it downfield, so I like that we're keeping him on their toes, mixing it up.
Second and three. We've got three wideouts to the right slot side along with a slot there, and Curtis on second and a long three. He's going to give on the jet sweep this way to Warmbrode. 50, and he'll lunge past the first down yardage to the 46-yard line. Plenty of room for the first down. So, Nashville Christian right off the bat, two positive plays, and with 9:34 to go on the clock ticking in the first quarter, in semifinal action at Nashville Christian in beautiful Bellevue, Tennessee, in a score that's knotted at zero, and the Eagles trying to knock first on the door. Wide outs to both sides. We got JT Robbins kind of at a flanker right. Tailback, Cam Carden. Sends a motion. JT comes this way. Curtis will give. Cam Carden, 45, 40, 35, 31-yard line before he's ridden out of bounds. Again, great yardage, but we've got a yellow handkerchief back at the 45-yard line, and that's going to be holding on Ezel Harding, so the nice run is negated. And how many times have I seen that on this field over the last 12 years? And I always ask Coach Brothers, are we holding that much? And I'm sure he's partial to the Eagles, but he says, no, we're not. I'm sure we do a few times. But, Chandler, there's holding on every play.
Well, I think Peyton Woodard put a wrestling move there on one of the defensive linemen that I was able to see. So I think he wasn't going to be able to get away with that one very easily.
We've got three wide outs to the right, one to the left. Jared Curtis back to pass, a little out pattern here to Smith, and he gets back some of the penalty yardage, and it's going to be about second and 11, and so we push the ball back into their territory. The ball will be placed at Jackson Christian's 47-yard line as the Eagles dressed in their blue and white uniforms and nice-looking silver helmets. They've got big Cedric Anderson in there at 390, and I'd hate to have to push that kid around. And he's just a junior. He's still growing.
Whew.
Curtis in the pistol. Brings Warmbrot in motion this way. Fakes the jet sweep. He runs out of the pocket. He could run. Now he's bringing the ball back this way. And now he's going to throw the ball sidearm. It's complete to Warmbrot at the 35. He's still on his feet. Spins to the 31, to the 32. Finally brought down at the 30. And what a circus play that was. That was quite a play that time. And hopefully we can show it to you in just a second. We'll try to bring it to you here in just a second, I hope. We're going to try to do a little instant replaying here. Throw the ball sidearm is complete to Warmbrot at the 35.
There he is.
He's still on his feet. Spins to the 31, to the 32.
Great job by Warmbrot.
Finally brought down at the 30, and what a circus play that was. Bobbles the ball, picks it up. He's going to run. It's got running room, 25, 20, 15, 10. Carries the ball inside the 10-yard line to the 9. Great run that time as Curtis dribbled the ball off the surface, bounced it back up like a basketball, and takes it down to the 10. And that should be first and goal as the ball is nosed just over the 10-yard line.
Wow, love the improv there. He's able to make something out of nothing make look very easy.
We have a full house backfield, a diamond formation. It's called full house when I was little. Bryson Holt in the back of it. He's going to get it. 10, stutter steps, 5, pushes actually closer to the 6, did not quite get to the 5-yard line. So we're bringing in Warmbrot, Smith, and Satterfield back into the contest. DeMumbrium comes out along with Potts. And it's second down and goal at the 7, so he only got 3. Cam Carden in the back at the tailback spot behind freshman Jared Curtis. 0-0 our score. Ball goes to Cam right up the middle. Spinning to the 4, to the 3, to the 2. They throw him down at the 1. And that's going to bring up third and very short is the Eagles knocking at the door first. And I apologize, our camera angle, as we say every week, is so low. The ball is actually about the 2-yard line. So I missed it by a yard. So Cam Carden still in at their tailback spot. Let's see if we just try to pound it off tackle. And we come once again in the diamond formation, or as we said back in the 70s, full house backfield. Curtis is going to give to Carden right up the middle. He'll walk in the end zone. They won't even touch. Excuse me, Bryson Holt. I'm sorry, Bryson. Touchdown, Nashville Christian. Thank you, Chandler Clark, for being able to see much better than I can.
Only with my glasses, Mike.
So we draw first blood at the 5:42 mark. We take the lead, and Wyatt Martin will be in. Devin Ray will be the snapper. The holder, James Warmbrot. Wyatt Martin to kick. Snap, ball placed, kick up. Kick is going to be good. It's good. Nashville Christian draws first blood at Eagle Field in the first round, the semifinals of the state playoff on a cold, frosty night, leading Jackson Christian, 5:42 to go, first quarter, 7-0, back in a moment. Back at Eagle Field, we're ready for the kickoff. Wyatt Martin is going to boom it. The ball will be fielded about the 5, 10, 15, 20, lunging past the 25-yard line, and Jackson Christian will be putting the ball in play. Bryson Holt, who just scored the touchdown with the tackle. And so Jackson Christian has a formidable foe in these Eagles, as we're used to being in this situation. And we've had an incredible year, only a couple of close games after the first two one-possession losses. We've kicked a lot of people off the field, but I know Jackson Christian didn't come up here to get kicked off the field. And here is a gift to their running back, number three, Cameron Boyd. And he is brought down by Potts.
That's your division leading tackler right there. Had 88 on the season, 18 for loss before tonight's game.
So it'll be second down and eight. Quarterback Kelly back there in the gun with Boyd. He's only 5'4", but he can fly. Back to pass. Out pattern is complete. Nice catch, nice throw. And he's going to pick up first down yardage and more. He's jittering. He's still on his feet to the 50, to the 40, to the 30, the 20. This is Jalen Mosley. He's going to go all the way, and that's going to be 72 yards. And what a jitterbug he did over there on the sideline to escape and go the distance. And Chandler, they're right back in it.
Missed tackles was the name of the game there. And he only really had two guys to beat. Kind of had everybody on the other side of the field here. So got to give the shout-out to Jalen Mosley, able to shift his way all the way down there, 72 yards.
One of the longest plays we've given up this year, and number 14 is going to kick the ball, Zach Sisko, and he has knotted it at 7 with 4:38 to go. So with that, here's some words that Coach Jeff Brothers had before the game.
Just excited to be back in the semifinals. We've had a good week of practice. Playing a really good opponent. They've been putting up 41 points a game. They've got a running back that's a Mr. Football semifinalist. We're going to have to contain him and limit big plays there in that running game. And then they have some quality receivers they can throw to as well. And some ability to score in different ways, and so we're going to have to play solid defense, and offensively we just can't have empty possessions. We can't get on the plus side of the field and come away with nothing. We've got to take advantage of our opportunities when we get them, because they can score, and so we're going to have to just play a good solid game in all three phases. And the team that it's cliche, but the team that makes the fewest mistakes is going to have the best opportunity to win, and we've got to work hard to make sure that's not us.
Alright, Coach Jeff Brothers on his comments on Jackson Christian, and they have tied this thing up. Zach Sisko, who just tied the game up, will be kicking. And it's a squibber down the middle. It's going to be picked up. And is there illegal procedure? I believe there is.
Don't normally see that on a kickoff.
Right. So, offsides. And so somebody got across that line, so that's going to back it up to the 35. So we'll redo it, 35-yard line. So hopefully we can get a good return and be back in business. Zach Sisko, junior, to tee it up. And this one is kicked deep and caught at the 11-yard line. 15, the 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. That's Donovan Smith past the midfield stripe, and Smith brings it back. And we're right back in Jackson Christian territory, right up the gut, Chandler.
Whew, he's dangerous. Don't give him space. Don't give him room to move, because he will make you look silly.
Ball at the 43-yard line. First and 10, Nashville Christian. Jared Curtis will be in the gun. He's got Carden on his left hip. And he's going to give Carden right tackle. Stutter stepping, gets outside 40, cuts back 35, lunging down to the 32. That's going to be another first down for the Eagles. as they have not shown they can stop this running game at all, Chandler.
Yeah, that, we got three first downs on the first drive, and it was primarily from the run game. Jared, you know, with the bobbled snap, and Cam with some other some nice runs as well. So we'll see if they mix it up any over the air, or will they stick to what's been working?
Curtis, slot with JT. He's going to give to Cam. No, he's back to pass. Throwing the ball in the corner of the end zone. That ball is going to be – is that going to be caught, ladies and gentlemen? Yes. Touchdown, Donovan Smith. Beautiful aerial into the corner.
Curtis.
Nice job. Slot with JT. He's going to give to Cam. No, he's back to pass.
Oh, they
throwing the ball
in
the corner of the end zone. That ball is going to be
at the
– is that going to be caught, ladies and gentlemen?
And we had a big head that got in the way of the catch also.
So back to live action. Ball at the one-yard line. Great play, great aerial. Bryson holding the back of the eye. Will he get his second touchdown? Curtis is going to sneak, and they piled it up pretty good, but did he score? The officials are running in from both sides. The Eagles say they've scored, and the officials agree. Touchdown, Curtis! The Eagles take the lead, 13-7, 3:35 of the first quarter. And Wyatt Martin in to tack on the point after. Devin Ray, our short snapper. Warmbrow to hold Martin to kick toward the school again. Snap, placement, kick, end over end is good. And there's timeout on the field with a score. Nashville Christian in the semifinals of the state, 14, Jackson Christian 7. We're 2 of 2 on our possessions. And when we come back, Jackson Christian will try to strike again like they did last time with a 72-yard pass down the sideline. Back in a moment.
Just said that.
All right, we're ready to resume play. Wyatt Martin to kick it up, and Chandler, three touchdowns in the first quarter. And at this rate, we're going to be here a while.
I'm having sneaking suspicions this could be similar to that shootout we had against Davidson here, but I don't know. Hopefully the defense, our defense, will clean it up after giving up that big touchdown.
And here's the kick. He lines it nicely all the way back to the 5-yard line, bringing the ball back. That's Jack Collins. And he's going to get back to the maybe just to the 20-yard line where the Eagles pile him up and hitting him, I believe it was Michael Hoskins, number 22.
Freshman.
Yeah, these freshmen are in my class, and they do a good job in the classroom, and they do an outstanding job also out here on the field. So, Jackson Christian, Kelly brings his team up. And he's got three wideouts to the right side, and there's a quick screen over there. And he's going to get to the 25, to the 27, but he ran out of real estate. Pushing him out of bounds was number 3, Braylon Toll. And he's going to get a good pickup of close to 7 yards. It'll be second and a long 3. No huddle, quick snap. They give to the man off tackle. He's going to spin to the 35, to the 40. There, he's carrying tacklers to the 41. That's Cameron Boyd. And, man, he cut against the grain and picks up a nice first down. Immediately there to the line. This looks like Tennessee. They are quickly getting stuff going here. Wide out play to the left side. And he's going to spin away, and he's not going to get a first down running, but he will with a penalty as we've got a face masking over on the sideline. So Jackson Christian, they are trying to answer the bell again here, and down 14-7, they will move the ball inside Eagle territory.
We certainly haven't seen a team run a hurry-up style offense yet, and not only that, but they've got weapons. They've got guys who can make some plays. We've already seen Mosley break one for 70 plus, and we saw an incredible jump cut from Boyd. And so they're going to have to really stay disciplined here and not let it throw them off their game.
Ball at the 38. They come right out of the huddle quickly. 2:53 to go, first quarter. Eagles up 14-7, but the other Eagles are trying to punch it in. Off tackle, number 23 is running. He's going to lunge forward for some good yardage also. And that's Mosley, who's done quite a bit tonight. And Woodard from the tackle spot brings him down.
Mosley's big. I didn't realize until he made a little sideline play over here that he's a strong, big force, different, you know, build than Boyd, who's a little leaner, a little smaller, but a lot shiftier. So,
second down and five as he gets a nice pickup ball down to the 33. Jackson Christian answering the call. Their fans are back into it. Back to pass. Looking, waiting, throwing down the sideline. He's got a man. Goes up for an incredible grab, but he's incomplete because he's out of bounds. Warmbrode had great coverage, but going up, Mosley, he's a 6'1 sophomore, and he did a basketball leaping rebound to get that ball, but he was out of bounds and just ran out of real estate, or they would have had a big gain down at the goal line. So our crowd below trying to urge on the defense. Jackson Christian fans across the way standing for their Eagles. Third and five, ball to the three. Tight end to the right, receivers to the right. And it's going to go up the middle. That's going to be plenty of room for Boyd. Boyd carrying down to the 26-yard line. And another nice drive here, Chandler, by the Eagles from the west side of the state.
Boyd goes to the sidelines to get some air. Get some oxygen, get some water. So we'll see. Do they go to Mosley? They got a big tight end as well. They got a 6'6", 220 tight end, number 85. I wonder, will they start getting him involved as well in the passing game, not just in the blocking game?
26-yard line. We've got a four-man front. Now we shift to adjust to their alignment. And it's going to go off tackle to number one. And he's going to lunge forward for a few yards. And that's Elijah DeMoss. And he's going to get... Let's see where they place it. Not too much. He got maybe about a yard. It's second down and seven. Ball on the 26. 1:13 to go. So we're winding first quarter action down. Jackson Christian trying to put one in before the first canto is over. I don't know what canto is. It just sounded good. 1 minute exactly left in the first quarter. Second down and seven. Ball on the 23. And it's going to go off tackle to him again. And he breaks one tackle, not another. He's not going to get a first. It looks like they're going to line it up about 2 yards short. Let's see exactly where they put it. The 23-yard line was where the play ensued. It's now down to about the 18. Looks like third and two. Big play. 37 seconds and your clock ticking. Jackson Christian in their white shirts and blue pants coming to the line against the all-navy blue of Nashville Christian. Third down and two. Big play here. Man in motion left side. Ball is going to go to their man, Boyd. Boyd trying to get outside to the 15, 14-yard line. Is he going to be short? I don't think he got it. It's going to be close, I believe. Donovan Smith with a nice tackle. The clock is stopped for the first down, and so we're going to probably end the quarter on that note, Chandler. 5 seconds, it'll tick on out of here. And Chandler, they're knocking at the door. When we come back, they've got 14 yards to tie it up.
I mean, it's looked like two high-powered offenses that where the defenses just haven't had answers yet. So maybe this game could come down to a fourth down stop late in the game if it's just going to go back and forth and ping-pong like this. And I like our chances if that's the case. We've had to stand up late in games. I think that's how the Davidson game ended, where we had a late fourth down play from somebody.
Well, we're going to go to the second quarter here as we show on the Jumbotron some of our sponsors. And as we return to action, as the Eagle defense marches back out onto the field, and they would love to get a stop here and keep them out of the end zone. It's down on the 14-yard line, first down, as they're moving right to left. If you're listening on your radio dial on the interstate, headed somewhere. And sorry we can't do shout outs because NFHS, whatever those initials are, is broadcasting the game live while we're doing the delayed broadcast. And as we said, if you're listening to this game, then you already know what happened. While we're talking here, we don't know. So it's first down and 10. And the ball, once again, wide right to Mosley. And we're going to hit him over there on the sideline. by a host of Nashville Christian Eagles. And so Jackson Christian knocking at the door, trying to get this game knotted up before a capacity crowd here on a cold, frosty one with temperatures starting to dip below 30 tonight. Second down and 10. No gain on the play. Jackson Christian was going with no huddle offense, trying to keep us on our heels. Now they're huddling to make sure they've got the exact play that coach wants. It's second down and 10. DeMoss is shifting to the left side. Pistol formation. And it's going to go to him up the middle. And we're going to hit him again. Cam Carden on the initial hit. It's going to get third down and long. So now we've got them in the position we like. Chandler, you want that third down and long.
You have two good runs that were stuffed there by the line. They haven't really tried anything down the middle of the field or anything like that like we've done throughout the game. They kept everything kind of towards the sidelines and in the hands of their running back. So you wonder if they've got something in their back pocket that they're waiting to set up when they see the formation they like, or if that's just going to be their MO all game.
Defense ready to come to the line. Offense is going to call a timeout. And we'll take a brief timeout as Jackson Christian wants to make sure they got the exact play that they want. And with the score, as we've just begun play in the second quarter, Nashville Christian 14, our visitors from Jackson Christian in West Tennessee 7, the semifinals. This is the next to last round of the state playoff. Nashville Christian 14, Jackson Christian 7. So big play for both teams here. The Eagles bring their defense back out. Jackson Christian sets down. Running back Boyd.
Got one-on-one coverage here at the bottom of your screen. Braylon Toll on number 13.
On third and 10, back to pass. Rolling to the right, throwing the ball in the end zone. He's there, and did he catch it? He caught it. And that was, guess who? Mosley. And Mosley has a pair of hands, and they are 1 point away from knotting this thing up. And four touchdowns, and we barely played a quarter.
This could be a video game score
here
where you just run it up the whole game.
So you can ignore the point differential between us playing Trinity and them, because this is a different scenario altogether. So Zach Sisko, did he tie it up? He nails it.
He missed it.
He drilled it but missed it. So a little bit of a momentum swing back to us. It's amazing what that 1 point does to momentum. And so we've got an Eagle on the field. Let's see if we can zoom up on him and find out who the injured Eagle is. Trainer's out to see him.
I think it's Kevin Bradley.
Kevin Bradley, Big Bradley, who missed the first couple of games with injuries, and hopefully he'll be back for us in a second. So the missed point after leaves us with a 1 point lead, but it is, in essence, I guess you could say a one possession game, but they can easily tie it up with a 2 point conversion if we score again. So they're going to help Bradley up. I think he's going to be okay, hopefully. He is limping, though, and favoring it. So they're going to have to help him off. That's Coach Brothers helping him off.
Oh, barely any weight on it. Not much at all.
Hope that's not a bad sign.
So we'll have to look for who replaces Kevin, a senior, final game at Keaton Field.
So, Chandler, be looking at what's our weather here. For some reason, I'm not picking it up.
Well, I know where I live in Hermitage, it's 34, so I'd imagine it's pretty similar there.
We're here. So we're not down into the 20s yet. We probably will be by the end of the game, or at least hovering around 30. So still barely above freezing. So hopefully you're watching this game on Saturday in a nice warm spot, or on Sunday. Last week we had 2,000 views over the weekend of our YouTube that Mr. Atkins places for the kids and parents and families to enjoy. I think that was a record for us. So Jackson Christian in a 14-13 game is going to kick off, and we've got some scat backs, but they're going to kick it. It's going to bounce and be picked up by Satterfield. He's coming up the middle, 40. Let's make that Smith, 45, 40, 35, 30, all the way down inside the 20-yard line. Nice run that time. And we're going to try to show you that again.
Catbacks, but they're going to kick
and
it.
Here it is. It's going to bounce.
He got it off the bounce
by Satterfield. He's coming up the middle, 40.
Let's make that Smith, again. And there he
45,
the outside.
40, 35,
and
30, all the way.
The defender gets a decent angle on him and brings him down.
So we've got the team in action at the 21-yard line after a nice return by Smith. And Jared Curtis, freshman, brings us out, brings the play out to the team. Cam Carden is going to sit down behind him, behind the gun. 10:05, second quarter. Curtis gives to Cam, left side, and they're going to pile it up there in a nice defensive stand by the right side of that line. Hitting him first was Cedric Anderson. Big tackle over there. 390 junior. And he really plugged up the hole there that we were trying to open up. And nice containment by that side of the line for Jackson Christian. Your clock running down to 9:35. Nashville Christian here in a shootout so far. Brock Haywood is in. And he's going to be on the left hip of Curtis. It goes to him. He's going to sweep wide right. Does he get it? Run room. Gets a block on the corner. Cuts inside 15. Lowers his head and booms down to the 10-yard line. But yellow laundry back on the field. And Chandler, looks like we got a holding.
Yeah, I think it was on Warm Road, trying to create a lane for Brock. I don't even know if he needed to. Brock was coming down full head of steam. Trying to kind of cut the corner here. But it's going to back us up, which gives Jared a little more room to launch it downfield, which he likes. I kind of wondered, you know, with the shorter field ahead of him, is that going to change up the play calling? But
right.
Could be a blessing in disguise.
Ball at the 30, second down and about 20. Haywood back there again on the left side this time. Warren Brode on the slot right. Or flanker right, actually. Now he's going to go in motion. Curtis rolling to the left, looking to pass. Pass down and out is complete. And that was caught by Smith. Smith will get a couple of yards. The ball stays in play. And Nashville Christian will face a third down and looks like about 12 yards to go. Eagles to the line. Crowd trying to catch its breath here. We've got three wideouts coming over here and a slot with Warm Brode in it. Holt in front of him. And Jared back to pass. Steps up into the pocket. A jump pass is complete to Smith. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Give him 6. Touchdown, Eagles. 8:28 to go. A slant pattern. He looked like he was going to run and then jumped up in the air, and a great job that time.
It's
another play.
Another bag of tricks that Jared has. The jump pass, we hadn't seen that one yet this season. I guess he was saving it for a huge playoff game.
We'll try to give you a replay here after the kick, and it was a great play. White Martin in, and it's a big one because it will force them into a two-point conversion scenario. If he makes it, 20-13. And the officials are discussing something. We'll go ahead and show you that play.
And here it
Holt
is
in front of him.
Curtis.
And he's and back Jerry to pass.
Back
it
to
looks
pass.
Like he's going to run. And
steps
jumps
up
into the pocket.
A
jump
pass
is complete to Smith. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Replays are brought to you by Andrew Atkins,
our fearless leader,
communications director, Nashville Christian. Here's our snap. And the placement and the kick. And he's going to give us an 8-point lead. Good. There's timeout on the field with the score. Nashville Christian 21, Jackson Christian 13 in the semifinals of Single A Private School State Championship. Chandler, we've got, according to my Antioch math, 5 touchdowns up on the board. We've got 3 of them. I hope we'll be at least 1 ahead of them when it's all over. We do not apologize for being homers. We are for Nashville Christian.
Of course.
But we do respect the other team, and Jackson Christian has come up here to play, and the ball is kind of punched, fielded out of bounds. That ball's loose back there, and he picks it up, and now he's going to get something out of it. No, they're going to wield him dead at – where he picked it, the fumble back up. Boy, that ball lay precariously loose on the ground for a few moments.
Needed a couple of chances to get after it.
And the ball will be all the way back about the 11-yard line. And here comes Jackson Christian onto the field. First down, ball on the 12. Boy, it's been a wild one so far, 21-13. Kelly is going to give to his man, Boyd. He breaks one tackle, pushes forward. Woodard drags him down after a short gain. Looks like he's going to pick up about 4, though. Good run. And second down and 6. Nashville Christian up to the line with the 4-man front. 7:59 to go. Kelly is going to give to Boyd again. Boyd is pounding at the right tackle, and we snuff him for maybe a yard gain, and that's about it. Vasily Santos, along with JT Robbins on the hit, 7:40 and counting. Kevin Bradley back into the contest.
Good to see him after being shaken up on the extra point attempt they missed earlier.
Nate Thompson had been filling in for him, rushes off the field. Vasily Santos, who is temporarily hanging up the ice skates while we play football. 3rd and 5, ball in the 17. Kelly back to pass. And an out pattern is, did he catch that ball between 2 people? He did. What a catch. Guess who? Jalen Mosley out to the 35. And a great play, and they are in business at the 35-yard line. Ball to Boyd again. He is hit right at the line, and throwing him back was JT Robbins from the linebacker spot. He's going to pick up about 2, 2nd and 8. The ball pushed to about the 37-yard line, 2nd and 8. Jackson Christian with a big first down that they needed. They would love nothing more than to eat up the clock and go in at the halftime tied up if they could get a 2-point conversion after a score. But they've still got 63 yards to go. 2nd and 8. Kelly pitching wide to DeMoss, and he's not going to get much over there, and he stays in bounds, and little if no gain. Let's see how much he got. He may have pushed forward for a yard, and they're going to give him that. It'll be third down and six. Ball at the 39. They've got to get it right to the 45. Exactly six to go. Third down. We'll set it for you. 21 to 13. 5:58. Crowd down below us shaking the press box. They are coming to life. Back to pass. Kelly under pressure. Spins away. Throws the ball away out of bounds. Will he get an intentional grounding? There was nobody over there. The officials do not throw the flag. Bradley and Robbins were all over him, and he just hurled it into the bench over there. But it's fourth down, and we're going to get it on the punt. And now we're up. Boy, look at this formation here. Lonesome Polecat over here on the left side. Mm-hmm. And we're going to call a timeout to make sure we know how to cover this. So fourth down and five. Fortunately, we had three timeouts in our pocket. Coach Brothers uses one of them. When we come back, fourth down and five, ball on the 39, 5:43 to go. Eagles up over the Eagles, 21-13. All right, we're ready to resume play, and they're going to come back with the same formation. Chandler over here is most of the line. Let's see if they shift back over. They've still got plenty of time on the play clock. Let's see. Are we going to come and rush that? And, no, he's going to run. He's going to try to get it. He's going to come close, and he got it. And he ran right out of bounds at the 48-yard line. And our defensive setup is upset with how they got that, but they executed it to perfection.
It was a good scheme. It kind of looked like they were going to throw it over here back to this side. They had the numbers advantage over here. And they even had a little acting going on and like you threw it over here.
But they saw it was he read the defense nicely. Jackson Christian still driving, still in business. Pass a slant that time, no good to Mosley. We were fortunate it hit his hands covering Smith. The clock stops, second and 10, ball on the 47. 5.5 minutes left in the second quarter as the officials replace the ball at the line of scrimmage. And packed stands over there on the other side. We've got an overflow crowd on this side on a really cold 32 degrees, 34, some wherever you're at. And the ball is going to Boyd, left tackle. Going to stumble forward for about one. He's going to be hit by Kevin Bradley. And it will be second down. No, third down and am I saying third down right? Yes, there we go. I thought I saw it right. Third and nine, ball 48. Eagles want to get the ball back before the half and go up by two scores. Jackson Christian trying to go in and knot it up at the half. 4:59, they've had a good drive, but it is third and long at this time. Boyd back there with Curtis. Cooper Bankley out here to the side. He's back to pass, rolling, looking, waiting. He's in trouble. He throws it away. And we're hoping for a intentional grounding, but he was outside the pocket. And who was putting the pressure on him? Potts. Potts from his lineman spot. Fourth and nine, so let's see what Jackson Christian does. They don't want to leave us with a short field. We can take that thing in pretty quickly from 47, 48 yards away.
They got a normal-looking formation this time.
Yeah, looks like they're going to punt it away. Zach Sisko does the kicking and punting. And we are coming. Oh, Bristol just about got it. Bryson just about got it. Ball rolls out of bounds. Nashville Christian will get it, and they've got two timeouts and 4:30 to go. Curtis getting the play call from the coaches. See what we want to try to dial up here. Ball is back on the 15, first and 10, 21 to 13. 4:30 left in the half in the semifinals. The winner is going to Chattanooga 2 weeks from yesterday, a week from Thanksgiving. The single-A private school division does not play the weekend of Thanksgiving. Coach Brothers says he misses that. As a high school player at Brentwood Academy, he always enjoyed that Thursday game or Thursday practice, whatever the case may be. And we've got a wide-out pass over here to Smith, and he's met as the ball arrived, incomplete. 4:24 to go.
Fortunate there. Ricocheted off Donovan's hands and went right into the chest of the cornerback there, but thankfully he didn't have the wherewithal to reel it in. But that almost was a terrible accident.
If I said the ball was on the 10, it's actually on the 15, and it's 2nd and 10 to go. So Curtis will probably look to go upstairs. We've got 3 wideouts. Cam Carden back there with him. And here is a down and out pass. It's complete to Smith. Nice catch. He's knocked out of bounds at the 28, but it's a good enough for the first down and stops the clock at the 4:18 mark. 21-13. We've had 5 touchdowns in the first half, so a lot of fireworks. And if you didn't hear that, that's a Wyatt Martin barbecue first down. I wished whenever we got a first down, I could get some of that homemade banana pudding from Wyatt Martin Barbecue. It's actually Martin Barbecue. Wyatt thinks it should be named after him. And Cam is stuffed at the line. Cedric Anderson, once again.
He takes up a lot of space.
And he can move. Good ball player. Mm-hmm. Ball at the 28-yard line. It's going to be 2nd and still 10. Got to move to the 38th. The clock working. We've still got time and 2 timeouts. So Curtis, see if he goes upstairs. We've got Wormbrode and Sadler this way. Donovan Smith split out wide to the left toward the bench of Jackson Christian. Wormbrode in motion. He's going to get the jet sweep. Gets to the 30, stutter stepping to the 35, to the 40. Lowers his head and plunges past the 40-yard line and gets to the 42-yard line that time for a nice first down. We'll try to show you the action again. Jackson Christian. And here he is going in motion. He's going to get left sweep. Gets to the 30, stutter stepping to the 35, to the 40.
Nice run.
Lowers his head and plunges past the 40-yard line. Down to 308. National Christian really taking their time. They're going to have to speed it up here a little bit. I know they still got 2 timeouts left. 3 wideouts to this side, 1 to the other side. And here's Curtis just keeping it, and he's trying to bounce outside and does. 45-50, surge steps, 45. Carrying ball players defensively down to the 40-yard line. And we're immediately trying to get up. We'll try to show you the replay there
again. 2:43 to go.
And here's Curtis just keeping
there
it.
And he's
trying to bounce outside and does.
And 45-50.
For a nice gain
steps,
of about
45, 15
carrying
yards out to the 40-yard line.
Clock 2:30 to go. Cam Carden back there with Jared Curtis. Let's see what we go. And a slant pattern again to Smith. Pirouette to the 35, to the 30, to the 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, give him 6. Touchdown, Eagles! 40 yards. We punch out to 27-13 lead. 2:14 to go. Nice play, Wyatt Martin in.
Give him 2, Mike. That is 2 on the night for Donovan.
Wormbrode to kick. 27-13, 2:14 to go. This will make it a 15-point lead. Snap, kick, good. 28-13. Let's see if we can take another look at that pass, see what we go.
Here
and
we go.
Slant pattern again to Smith.
He pirouettes
at the 35,
nice
to
job.
The 30,
turns
to the
it
25,
field.
20, 15,
by
10,
tackler,
5,
takes it into
4,
the end zone
3.
For a nice run.
He's just too quick,
he
too
is.
Shifty.
Reminds me of your speed, is that right?
Oh, no, yeah. No. I mean, man, and one of the things I love about Donovan, too, on the basketball court, I mean, it's like jazz. It looks like he's always panicked, but he moves, you blink, and he's gone. His agility is insane.
Our basketball teams opened last night. Our girls had a good game against Harpeth Hall and handled them nicely. Our guys had a great first half with 22 points against Overton. But injuries and not having everybody back from football yet, we got kind of worn down there, but showed a lot of good stuff there in the first quarter last night. So later on in this month, we'll be bringing you some basketball also. This is our last telecast either way. They don't let us do the state championship. Wished we could. Maybe Mr. Atkins could sneak a camera into the stadium and we'll bring an impromptu game. White Martin to tee it up. 28-13. Boy, that's a big score right there. And here's the kick. Line drives it over to the left side. Bobbled again. Picked up. 20. 25. And he's not going to get past the 26. Bringing him down is JT Robbins. 28-13. 2:06. Let's see what Jackson Christian can do. What a momentum lift if they took it all the way in, Chandler. But they've got a long way to go. They've got 68 yards. What is that, 75 yards?
Mm-hmm.
Just under 75. 2:06 left. Here we come to our defensive line. Kelly back to pass. He's going upstairs, down the sideline again. Did he catch it? Caught it. What an incredible grab by this time Lance Rowland. And what a play that time. They're going to run the length of the field with no huddle. What an incredible play. 1:57 to go. And they are now in scoring distance immediately, and a fine throw and catch. Jackson Christian to the line at the 38-yard line. Slot to the left, one receiver to the right. He's coming in motion this way to Boyd. Misdirection, gets off tackle. Picking up nice yardage, about 8 yards there. The ball carrier, Boyd, brought down. They quickly run to the line of scrimmage, 1:45 and ticking. They've still got two timeouts. Time should not be a big factor for Jackson Christian with the time they have. And Curtis with a little out pattern deflected and knocked down nicely by Bryson Holt. Well, he got a hand there. That would have been a completion probably. Third down and two. So a big play coming up for Jackson Christian. 1:31 to go. They trail in the semifinals of the state tournament at Eagle Field in Bellevue, 28-13. Ball exactly on the 30, third and two. Crowd coming to life below us. Big crowd on hand on a frosty night. Here's Kelly back to pass, throwing the ball long into the end zone, just over the hands, incomplete. That was Jalen Mosley. We're going to show you the play that the long bomb he threw a while ago. Kelly back to pass.
This is a big play to get them down
inside
our territory.
Down the sideline again. Did he catch it?
He had good coverage. Caught
it. What an incredible grab by this time Lance Rowland.
It was.
So he's had a couple of good passes. Ball to 39. It's four down territory, fourth down and two. Field goal too far away. Field goal would be big, but they've got to get a first down here because we get the ball at the half, at the third quarter. Here's Kelly on fourth and two, and there's a whistle that were given to Boyd up the middle, and Jackson Christian must have felt like they did not have the right call, so they wisely use a timeout. We'll take a brief timeout with the score. Nashville Christian 28, Jackson Christian 13. As both Eagle teams will be back in a moment. All right, here we go, the fourth down play. Fourth and two. Let's see what Jackson Christian can dial up. They're giving to Boyd. Did he get it? It's going to be close. He leans forward. Both teams say the carry favors them. And Potts is being talked to by the official. Not sure exactly what happened. Woodard with the stop. They're saying it is a first down. 1:09 to go. They're immediately to the line. They're at the 28-yard line, trying to cut this back to a one-score game. We're down to 1 minute. Kelly back to pass, and he is going to be thrown for a loss. Woodard back there with the limping Kevin Bradley. Look at Kevin Bradley limping there.
He is a warrior. He's not going to let his final game at Keaton Field as a senior go without him giving everything he's got.
Kelly back to pass.
Comes the pressure.
And he is going to be thrown for a loss.
Cameraman, so we
Woodard
missed the sack there. Sorry.
Back there with the limping Kevin Bradley. Look at Kevin Bradley limping.
But nice defensive play there. And second down and 10 with the ball on the 36. Big sack there. Pushes the ball back to the 36-yard line. So 2 weeks from tomorrow, yesterday, we're going to have the state championship with one of these teams down in Chattanooga. We were there last year, came in second place to DCA, and this a few weeks ago we thumped DCA off this field pretty good. Kevin Bradley is, I guess they can't take him out. He won't go out. Second down and 18, ball all the way back to the 36-yard line. Kelly desperately trying to get his team in the end zone before the half. Man in motion, Cooper Banky to this side. He's got a catch earlier. Here he goes. They're going for that corner route again. It's going to be way overthrown. Nothing there. Good coverage as the defense over there kind of bottled him up. That was Braylon Toll. Good job on the corner coverage over there. Now third down and 18, Chandler at the 36, and our crowd below will come to life for the defense. 45 seconds left. One timeout left for Jackson Christian. The white, blue, and silver to the line against the navy, blue, and auburn orange of Nashville Christian. Kelly back to pass, looking, waiting, throwing the bomb, way overthrown and almost intercepted by Warmbrode. And he just had too much on the arm that time. So it's fourth down and 18, and I'm imagining they're going to have to go for it. But if they don't, they're going to give us a decent field, but there's only 37 seconds left. Ball at the 36. So a big must down here for Jackson Christian if they hope to go in by a one-score deficit. It's currently 28-13.
If I'm the defense, I'm doubling Mosley because he has had probably already 10-plus targets and we're not even done with the first half.
Kelly back to pass. Here comes the pressure. Steps up. Throws it long downfield. That pass is, in and out of the hands. They had the reception, and we had coverage over there by Warmbrode, and that ball is incomplete, and we're going to get it on downs. Still a long way to go for us, but 29 seconds and two timeouts. Let's see what Coach Brothers dials up here, 28-13. So the big plays there by Jackson Christian went for naught. They got the ball down in striking distance, and then the big sack and then the incompletions, and we get the ball on downs at the 36. Curtis has the gun. Let's see if he throws it deep. 29 seconds left, 28-13. Nashville Christian leading late here in the second quarter. Curtis is going to fake back to pass, looking, waiting. He's throwing the ball down the sideline, looking here for Satterfield. Incomplete goes through his hand.
It was
a perfect pass. It was a perfect pass, but it apparently would have come back anyway. It looks like we've got a flag, and that's an ineligible receiver downfield. So I don't know who snuck past that line. And that will bring the ball back.
And that's Jared Curtis, slow to get up. He's seems a little out of it.
DeMumbrium into the contest. And they march the ball back to about the 31, 20 seconds left. So let's see if Curtis can sling a long one that we can run under. Some of these guys out here in short sleeves, they're tougher men than I am.
Mm-hmm.
20 seconds to go. Coming out here to the right side is Satterfield. He's by himself over here. Here's Curtis, he's going to give to Cam safely. 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. Pushing, lunging, turning, and carrying. Tacklers down to the 44-yard line. 10 seconds to go. And we're going to call a timeout, and we'll show you that play again. Curtis, he's going to give to Cam
nice
safely.
Nice safe playoff 30, tackle.
35, 40.
45.
And he's hit
50,
48,
pushing,
and
lunging,
carries
turning,
forward
and carrying.
For another 9 yards.
Tacklers
nice
down
play.
To the 40.
28-13. We have one timeout left. There are 10 seconds left. We're 44 yards from pay dirt. Let's see what we can get.
I feel like we had a similar situation in a different game in the regular season where it was right at the end of the half, and it may have been the Davidson game where they just kind of let Jared run around back
yeah.
and forth and just launch it downfield, and we were able to make it a touchdown reception on that play. So you wonder, will they just send everybody down there and do something similar?
The Eagles come racing onto the line of scrimmage. And they've got the play. They've got wide outs over here, too, with Warmbrode and Satterfield. 10 seconds left in the half. We're at the 44-yard line. Back to pass Curtis. Got time. Steps up. Here's a down-out pass. It is complete. Satterfield steps out smartly at the 26-yard line. And we will have time to exchange. There's 4 seconds left. And we're going to have a Wyatt Martin field goal. Steps out smartly at the 26-yard line.
Place at the 32.
And we will,
it will be a 42-yard
field
goal.
Have time to exchange. There's 4 seconds. Ball placed at the 32. This would be a personal record for Martin. 4 seconds left in the half, 28-13. Devin Ray to snap. Warmbrode to hold from 42 yards. The snap, the placement. That kick, ladies and gentlemen, is angling its way just short as the horn sounds. We'll take a timeout as the Eagles, with a lot of momentum, leading Jackson Christian 28-13. We'll be back in about 15 minutes for the second half.
Here we go.
Back at Eagle Field in a nice warm press box. I'm here with president of our school, Connie Jo Shelton. Connie Jo, I guess it's nice to step in to the warmth.
Absolutely. I've been wondering when you were going to invite me in this season, so I'm thankful that I get to warm up.
We waited to the last one, saving the best for last. So this is our last game either way. So, Connie Jo, you've seen every game. You are at most of the contest on this campus. What do you like so far?
the intensity. It's fast, exciting. It's nice to see that our defense decided to step up and stop the ball some. But Jackson Christian, they're a great team. And I was just going to give a shout-out to their head of school, Dr. Mark Benton. He's one of my favorites.
All right.
So lots of heads of schools. We are friends with each other. He's been there for about 7 years. He's a great guy. And good competition tonight.
It is. Comparing sometimes apples to oranges, they just barely got by Trinity, and we thumped them, but it doesn't look like that tonight. We do have a two-score lead, but they came up here to play.
They sure did. Good contest.
So, all right, let's see. If we win, we're in the state championship, and that would be 2 weeks from yesterday. Is that correct?
That is correct.
On a Thursday, correct?
Mm-hmm.
And
you know, it's bad luck to talk about stuff like that.
Yeah, I know, but since this is the last time in the press box, I don't guess you can tell what we're going to do school-wise on that day. That's not allowed to be leaked out yet, is it?
Listen, I was raised by a football coach, and you don't plan ahead. You have to take care of tonight.
That's right. I ought to know that after coaching 78 years. I ought to know that. And I always like to bring up your great dad, Coach Donnie Keaton. Mm-hmm. He was a legend here. We had him at Ezel for a while, and just an incredible person. And he said something to me that when I was head coach in high school and middle school, that I've used ever since the 80s. And we were just talking about sometimes parents get a little too active, involved sometimes. I know they love their kids. But he was talking about when parents criticize the coach in front of the kids. And he said when a parent criticizes a coach in front of their child, not one good thing can happen. And I've never forgotten that. And I've told that at numerous parent meetings. And it is so true. So what are your football memories of Coach Keaton? I know there's a million.
I was going to say there are a million. It was fun. I mean, obviously, we're a family affair. We were. I remember when he was Ezel Harding, and you were the commentator up in the box at times. And so I think just that I think I learned the commitment of coaching. So I shout out to every coach in middle school, high school athletics, and the sacrifices that families give up for the coaches to be able to pour into kids. My dad was always a fan of kids, and if they worked hard and behaved, those were the two things that always stuck with me that he told kids over and over again. All you have to do is work hard, and all you have to do is behave, and great things will come your way.
He was a great sportsman also. He's one of those guys that I never heard opponents or officials talk bad about. I think he had that respect in the mid-state from everybody involved in high school football back then.
Mm-hmm.
So here on our plant, you get to enjoy working with your children every day.
I do.
And Sonia, that's got to be neat.
Yes, it was an adjustment at first. So last year when we did new teacher in service and both of my kids were there, it was a little different. But I will say that I'm really proud, and all three of my kids work in education. And
that's neat.
I think a lot of times educators will push their kids in different ways, mm-hmm. just financially, that you might want to make a different choice. But I have to be honest to say it thrills my soul that they've all three chosen to work in schools and pour into the lives of children. It's been a passion for me, and I'm really proud of them.
Well, and I was honored to have both of them in class, and so proud they pulled that D minus in my class both times. And barely skimmed by, and I gave them a lot of bonus points. So
thank you, Coach.
I loved having them in class, and they're still fun to cut up with. They've got great personalities. Well, what about the plan itself? There's a lot of plans for the future. We've done a lot recently. There's some beautiful playgrounds. There's extra place for track and field to train. So talk to us a little bit about the plant and facilities itself.
I think it's just been so exciting. We've had two ribbon cuttings and a groundbreaking this year. So it's been fun. We did a ribbon cutting of the wrestling facility a couple of weeks ago. We opened up the school year with an outdoor classroom, and then it was an incredible event this week. We did a groundbreaking for a golf training facility. And
awesome.
The Brant Snedeker Foundation, Tennessee Golf Foundation, and Avid Foundation. So three foundations came together to partner with us to provide, we'll start working on this golf facility.
Awesome.
So it's fun to have a vision. I got to give a shout out to Coach Sig and his vision and how hard he works for facilities and for athletics. And so just, and with Jeff Fincher, Dr. Jeff Fincher, our Chief Development Officer. So great things are coming. We're working really hard on an event center and to remodel the Gibson Center as well. So really great things coming with that as well.
That's going to be a major renovation and improvement. Sadly, I probably won't make it to that point. I hope I do.
I think you will.
I hope so. I really want to see it. And that will make this campus absolutely fantastic. Mm-hmm. And it's already a pretty place. We're nestled here into the woods a little bit from the interstate. And it's just, it's very picturesque here. Mm-hmm. I love having the trees all around us. It's really a neat layout, the stadium. I remember coming over here in the 80s when I was doing the broadcast with the Ezo Harding. And to think about the upgrades we've made over here mm-hmm. and how it's just a handsome facility over here.
It sure is. And, you know, and the one thing, too, while we're focusing on facilities, I would just say also, I tell a lot of families that come and visit often, just give our people a chance. I mean, it's the people that make Nashville Christian.
Right.
It's not the buildings. It's not, you know, it's just all, I just can't say enough about our employees, our faculty and our staff and how they pour into the lives of children. It's just overwhelming and it makes me so proud.
And one thing that that I have appreciated here, every school has teacher turnover. There's different reasons people have to leave, retire, whatever. But we've got a lot of people here that's been here a long time. And we've got people in the business office and the staff. They're 40 years, 35 and 40 years. That's incredible.
Yeah. Yeah, that's Miss Linda Brown. I mean, she's just she's the standard here, and how hard she works and what she's done to dedicate for Nashville Christian School is just phenomenal. And when I was a student here, she was a secretary, and we loved walking in the office to see her. So the only thing I kind of hate about how we've restructured some areas is kids don't get to spend much time with Linda Brown.
Right, just an incredible person, and She helped keep the Nazis out of Bellevue back in the 40s, and she's still with us now, and we're so excited. I hope she'll hear that comment. But thanks for stepping in. I know it's nice and warm. We're not live, so everybody watching this is seeing this the day after, and so everybody knows while watching what happened. Right now we're sitting here trapped in this moment and don't know what's going to happen, but we're hoping we're going to be playing down in Chattanooga in a couple of weeks.
Hopefully so.
Ms. Connie Jo, thank you for coming in, and thank you for giving me a job. I've enjoyed these last 11 years a whole lot, so thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
Appreciate it.
We love having you, Coach Mike.
Thank you a lot.
Uh-huh.
All right, we've got about 4:50 on the clock. We'll be back for the second half in just a few minutes.
producer Andrew Atkins is doing a little walkthrough through our press box and give you a view of what we see up here. And over on the far side, we've got former Vanderbilt play-by-play announcer Joe Fisher and their crew is out here doing the play-by-play. And this is our group that keeps up with the score, does the PA. There they are right there. And those guys do a great job. And they keep the crowd informed. And now we're back inside our little booth here. And it's a cold one out there. And both teams are back out in the warm-up right now. So that's the view we have out our window right there. And so it's a great view here in growing and gracious Bellevue, Tennessee. And here's Jalen Boone. She is doing our computer graphics today. There's Jalen, one of our sophomores, and Colin Sawyer, is up on top, and he is doing our filming and does a great job, one of the best we've ever had do that. So the clock is just about ready to wind down for halftime, and we're going to bring you back to an exciting semifinal action here for our third quarter kickoff in just a moment. Mr. Andrew Atkins is down in the cheering section, and there's some of our fans there, a great crowd, and they're showing their enthusiasm and their fatigues, and they've been quite loyal tonight, and a good crowd here for a frosty night.
It's like a Bass Pro Shop outlet store down there. I can see a lot of camo, No deer stands, though.
Was it Rod and Rifle? So they are...
enjoying the game. It is chilly, and there's part of our crowd there. And I said capacity. If everybody sitting in the end zone and standing on the sidelines was in the crowd or in the stands, it would be overflow. So a great crowd here for such a cold night. And we wish we could have brought this game live to y'all, because I know we favor Nashville Christian, obviously, and our Nashville Christian people like us bragging on our kids. And we try to do our best to – we're certainly, leaning totally on the side of the Nashville Christian, but we like to give the credit due to the other team, and hopefully we do that. So both teams have gone back to their sidelines, and Nashville Christian is going to be receiving the kick, and so that's going to be big for Jackson Christian to keep us out of the end zone here. Well, we'll bring you some basketball action, and that'll be coming up here soon, as both teams opened last night. But business at hand, football. Nashville Christian ready to receive the kick. So the Eagles, after losing two close games to begin the year, have won nine in a row, going for their 10th win. We are 9-2. Is that right? Is my math correct?
Yes, indeed. I think Jackson Christian only lost one game in the regular season.
Then they defeated MTCS last week, 27-25, and boy, that was a close one. So we're ready for the kick. Zach Sisko to kick, and he's going to pooch it very short, and we catch it and immediately fall to the turf. Jaden Satterfield with a nice drop. Was that Blair Otero? I'm sorry. Thank goodness you're young and you can see.
Yeah, nice job by the freshman there to secure. They went for a little pooch kick.
Yep.
I was worried they were going to go for a little onside kick.
It looked like it at first. 46-yard line. Nashville Christian will put the ball in play on a frosty semifinal state championship night. Cam Carden back there behind Jared Curtis, the freshman. And it will go to him up the middle to the 45. And they're going to plug that line up. A good defensive surge there, led by number 71. Cedric Anderson, he's been in on a whole lot of plays. They're going to give Carden 1 yard out to the 47-yard line. Second down and 9. Nashville Christian leading 28-13. 15-point game with the extra point miss by Jackson Christian. And now we've got a man in motion, Warren Brogdon on the jet sweep. No. Curtis keeps it, cuts up field, 50, pushes to the 45 and falls across the first down marker to the 44, and that will be first and 10. We fake the jet sweep to Wormbrode and then keep it off tackle, and nice blocking over on that side with Bradley and Ray and Woodard at the center spot. Ball to 44, clock 10:55 of the third quarter, score 28-13, Nashville Christian. NCS giving to Carden. 45, cuts against the grain, 40, 35, carries up to the 32-yard line. That's going to be another first down. We are on a nice little roll here, 10:40 to go, a couple of first downs, and we've got Jackson Christian on their heels, and Chandler, they can ill afford to give up a TD here. It would be difficult to come back against this team.
Absolutely, especially since our defense is starting to kind of figure out who their go-to guys are, what their go-to plays have been. They've been targeting Mosley and running through Boyd all night, but the defense is really shaped up after that big touchdown they gave up early.
Ball to 32. Curtis under center, and we've got either timeout or flags. It's a timeout. So Coach Brother saw something that was misaligned, and he'll call a timeout with a score. National Christian 28, Jackson Christian 13, 10:05 of the third quarter. Semifinal action on a frosty night in Bellevue. Back in a moment. Brock Haywood, he's back there on first and 10 in the backfield. Curtis under center again. And it goes to Haywood off tackle. 30, center steps, 25, 20. Nice job there running it. Right tackle. Great blocking over there with Kevin Bradley and Devin Ray. Excellent job there. And we'll give you a quick replay of that. Did we miss it? All right, we missed that one. We'll get the next one for you. 9:40 ticking. And we're going with Brock Haywood. And he's going to put Robbins at a flank. Two wideouts left. Here's Curtis. He's going to give to Otero. Haywood again. Sorry about that. And he's going to get really good yardage, punching forward with the interior of that line with a great thrust. And pickup of about 4, second and probably along 6. Maybe about 3.5 yards on the pickup. So we come to the line. Let's make it 2nd and 7. Curtis sending wide out to the left, one to the right. Smith over here on this side. Brock Haywood back there on his hip. Curtis gives to Haywood, sweeping wide, 20, 15, 10, cuts the Grinch gain. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Give him 6. Touchdown, Eagles! Great run off the blocking of Bradley and Ray and Smith over here. And we throw it into the end zone via the run. It's 34-13, and it's going to be tough for Jackson Christian here to make a comeback. Warm Broad to hold again, 34-13. This would make it a 3-touchdown deficit, the ball down. That kick headed toward the creek. I think he missed it. So Wyatt will be mad about that one, but still a 21-point lead, 34-13, and we'll give you replay on that fine run that time by Brock Haywood. And we're having a little technical difficulty. It's not. We're going to see if we can bring it up, and I think we're going inside. Brock Haywood back there on his hip.
Here's another look.
Gives to Haywood, sweeping wide, 20,
there on the
15,
corner.
10, cuts the Grinch
right game.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
The receivers do a great job blocking. We really don't give them enough credit for that. I was watching JT Robbins as well at fullback. They really direct where Cam and Brock were going the entire way, kind of following his lead. And so I want to give a huge shout-out to JT as well for all the – He's a bulldog in there. I mean, he just gets right after for blocking any guy.
Martin to tee it up. Jackson Christian receive it with a 21-point deficit. We don't mean to say they don't have a chance. It's just that in this situation, it'd be tough to come back 3 touchdowns. But we've still got a lot of time left. And ball fielded back inside the 5. And that's their man Mosley. And he's going to bring the ball back out to about the 24-yard line. But I know that over the last few years, Chandler, I have seen almost every year, not every year, almost every year, a team would lose in the regular season by at least 30 points, meet that team in the playoff, and pull an upset. I have seen that more times than I can count. But tonight, even though we haven't played them yet, they are down 21, and they desperately need to get something into the end zone on this drive. First down and 10, ball to 24, 8:42 to go. Third quarter action. State semifinals, man in motion. It's going to go instead back to Boyd, and he's trying to sweep outside. Looked like he had a little running room, but he carried for about 4 yards, so a good run. He picks up about 6. Robbins knocks him down. They quickly come to the line without a huddle. Settling their men down. Kelly looks. Back to pass, a wide out here, and it goes for nothing. No, he breaks away. Gets to the 27. We had him for a no gain, and on his own, he carries forward. And that was that Bosley again?
Oh, of course.
He's a player. He gets the ball to the – no, it's no gain. He got back to the line of scrimmage. He fought to get that. Third down and 7. Ball at the 28-yard line. Third and a short 7, long 6. 3 wide outs and a diamond set over on the right side. Quarterback Kelly looks like they're going to check off and switch the play.
Watch the
screen
there.
Flanker right. He's got Boyd back there on his hip. And it is. No, oh. It's a slant pattern, man. He had Rowland or Rowland, probably Rowland, on a slant pattern right in his hands for the first down.
Oof.
Well, that's a big one. They had a first down, and now they got a punt. They're too deep to go for it.
That was the chance they needed. He had some space, too. He had a good angle and one guy to beat. So they might be kicking themselves after that missed opportunity.
They could have got back in the game if that goes the distance. So as it is, we've almost gotten a couple of blocks. It looks like we're coming after it again. Let's see. And we are coming, leaping over the line. It's a bad punt. We're trying to get away from it, and they're going to down it to the 45. So not a lot of yardage on that punt, Chandler. And we have a short field, and that's not a good thing to give NCS.
I think the punter was worried about the Navy wave that was coming in straight in his face.
There were people leaping over the line. I don't know if that's legal in – well, yeah, it's legal. You can't go up the back of people. They actually outlawed that a few years ago. I guess you can – if you're strong enough to jump over people, it's legal. Ball at the 46 of Jackson Christian. And Cam Carden back there again in the tailback spot. Back to pass Curtis. Looking, waiting. He wants to unleash it long. Downfield toward the end zone. Is it caught? Give him 6. Touchdown, Donovan Smith. 46 yards right at the corner of the pylon. Give him 6 large ones. 40-13. Let's take another look. 6 yards right at the corner of the pylon.
And
give him 6 large ones. 40-13. Somehow we missed it. Not sure how. Anyway, for the conversion attempt. And we shift. Are we going to go for 2? We are all over the place. Potts is in the quarterback spot. He wants to run. He cuts down and falls down, and he's going to hear that. We're going to have to show that on an instant replay for Potts to enjoy. So let's show that
he's
one
in
again.
The quarterback spot.
Jaden was all ready. He's looking.
He's going
to
run.
In, and
he cuts down and falls down.
So mad.
He's going to hear that.
The
We're
team
have
is
to
laughing.
Show that on an instant replay.
Potts is the only one not laughing. But we take our score 40-13, and we'll be back in a moment. Well, the score has been pushed out to 40-13, and as Nashville Christian has done, Chandler, quite often, it's a tight game, and then all of a sudden, boom, lightning is striking all over the field.
The offense has been explosive all night. Donovan Smith has got 3 touchdown receptions, so he has been the MVP for sure.
And we'll see if we can find out about the other contest. Ball is kicked out of bounds for a penalty. And I believe they're going to bring the ball up to the 40-yard line. That's the high school rule. Actually, it's the 35. So while we look and scroll for the action in the other game, we'll see if we can pick up who might be our possible opponent. As probably pretty safe to say, we're not going to blow this one, Chandler.
We got Friendship Christian leading USJ 17-7, about 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. So a little more low scoring.
Yeah. So they're about the same place in the game we are. And here's Kelly. It's incomplete, almost intercepted by Holt. And he had 35 yards in front of him. And he started running before he had it. Man. 7:02. Thompson. Excuse me. Potts, Bradley at the tackles, Woodard and Santaz. They're ready to swallow somebody up. Demumbrium goes and picks up the tight end on the right. The ball goes to Boyd. And he breaks away. Nice run. Carries past the 40. Potts finally brings him down at the 42-yard line. Make it the 43. Second down and 8. Nice pickup by Cameron Boyd. He's had some good runs tonight. We've got third down and 8. Ball to 43. Jackson Christian in a world of hurt. They've played hard. They kept it close for a while. It's gotten away from them now. Here's Boyd. He's going to pick up nice first down yardage, but he may not have. They look like he had it, and we popped him. No, they're going to give him the forward progress. So a nice run. Boyd, two nice carries in a row. Carries the ball to just past the 45. We'll call it the 46 to help my math. First down and 10, 6:07. Your clock running in the third quarter of the state semifinal championship round with a winner to end up in Chattanooga in a couple of weeks. And here's another pattern. A quick semi-slant incomplete. Didn't look like Mosley was really looking for the ball in time. Looked like they had a little bit of communication.
Mm-hmm.
5:51, they bring the ball back. Clock has stopped 40-13 as we have exploded midway through the second quarter till now. Banky, closest to your screen. They realign. Kelly is going to give to DeMoss. He's running the right side and nothing doing. The Eagles, it's hard to run on them right now. Potts is just really determined after that extra point miss. My apologies to Jaden.
It's all in good fun.
Unfortunately, he'll be ribbed about that for a long time.
Well, he's still leading the division in tackles. Oh, yeah, he's for loss, so he's got plenty of positive.
Yeah, I don't think that'll take him down too far. Third down and about 9. Big play. Back to pass. Kelly airing it long down the sideline and almost intercepted. Donovan Smith back there bounced off his hands, and I would assume Jackson Christian at near midfield will go for it. It's fourth down and 10, and I think Kelly is staying in there for the fourth down attempt. He's got a good arm. He's thrown some accurate passes.
Mm-hmm.
A couple of them have been just out of grasp, but he has he's really got a good arm. He's just a sophomore. I don't know if we've mentioned that or not. So this kid is really – got a really good future here for the next couple of years. So we may see this team again down the road. And here he is throwing their same play down the sideline, and it is incomplete. They got two men over there on Roland, and it's just hard to get through both of them. So we'll get the ball on turnovers, 40-13, 4:51 left. Back in a moment. What was a close game in the first half has been blown open by Nashville Christian midway through the second quarter and on here into the third to take it to 40-13. Curtis will give to Carden, 45-40, 35, lowers his head 30, 25-yard line. He is running over people.
Whew.
Excellent run. We'll try to show you that again.
Take it to 40-13.
Barbecue first down.
Curtis will give
the
card.
Here's the replay.
45, 40.
Right up the gut.
Lowers
his head 30. 25-yard line. He is running over Thompson and Woodard, Bradley, Ray, and Rainey. They just opened up a great hole over there. Brock Haywood in the back behind Curtis under center at the 23-yard line. And we're going to go to Haywood. He's hit by the right side of that line, slung down for a couple of yards. Actually, the sling of the tackler enabled him to pick up a couple, and Caleb Newsom hit him first. He's going to get three down to the 19. Eagles may be taking their time on a few of these plays. They're not in a hurry, letting some clock tick down. Trying to get another one into the end zone here near the end of the third quarter. So we walk to the line slowly on a second down and six. 40-13 lead. Curtis under center again. Brock Haywood getting a few carries. Resting Cam Carden. And it's going to go to him. Trying to sweep wide to the 20-yard line and more. He's going to be just short of the first down marker, it looks like. We got a flag. It's on us. Is it holding, Chandler?
It is.
So the clock will be momentarily stopped for the penalty. 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Places the ball exactly on the 30-yard line.
I think it was on JT Robbins because I was seeing these hands, you know, the motion. Like, really? Me?
Looks like third and about 18. Curtis in a 40-13 game is back to pass. Rolling to the right. He's going to throw the ball. It is in and out of the hands of Demumbrium. He had it at the 15 and dropped it. And 3:22 stopped on the clock. Third down and 17. So we shuffle another unit in for another look, another set. Peyton Woodard. Bradley, your guards. Thompson, the center. Ray and Rainey, the tackles. JT Robbins back in. Warren Broad split out over here along with Satterfield. Smith on the far side. Curtis back to pass. And here's a quick one inside screen to Warren Broad. 30. Cuts against the grain and will not quite get back to the original line of scrimmage. It'll be fourth down. Dare we try Wyatt Martin? I don't think so. From here, it would be over 40 yards. I don't think we're going to go for it. I'd like to see him try it. 40-13. I know he'd like to redeem himself.
Mm-hmm.
So Curtis will be back there to air it out on fourth and about 13, actually. And he's back to pass. Looking, waiting, bullets it out here, incomplete. Trying to hit a diving Satterfield. The ball will go over on down. So one of the few times we've been stopped tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Have we been stopped tonight?
I think that was definitely our first turnover on downs or turnover in general.
Yeah. So that's the first time we haven't scored on a drive, I believe. Is that right?
I believe so.
So immediately Jackson Christian coming out with the ball on the 26-yard line to put the ball in motion. And they're really in need of a drive and a score here. 40-13, 2:37 left. And it's going to go to Boyd again off the left side. And he's had a good running room night. Boyd is hit by Potts, who is just everywhere. Just a lot of high-skilled people on this team. And Jackson Christian's got some, too. We're just a little bit too much for them tonight. They've had a great year. Second down and three for Jackson Christian Eagles. Here's a wide-out pass that's actually a lateral. He's going to scoot down the sideline close to first down. Toll on the stop over there on the far sideline, making it third down and two. Jackson Christian immediately to the line. Ball at the 35-yard line. They need about 2 yards. Big play here for Jackson Christian. They got three wideouts over here, and the ball instead to Boyd. Boyd trying to get back to the line of scrimmage. He's going to fall forward. Rainey and Bradley hit him. I don't think. Well, it will be close. They're eyeing it, and it looks like they're going to measure. The ball is at the 37, and they say that's enough. Coach Brothers is asking, why aren't you measuring? And it's too late now. They've moved the chains, and there's no replay. First down and 10. Coach Brothers not seeing things the way the official does. That's happened a few times in his career. Boyd sweeping right. They're going to knock him down in the back behind the line of scrimmage and hitting him over there. Bryson Holt, the freshman. He's going to lose about two. About one. He's going to be second 11. Ball back to the 35. The clock winding toward a minute here. In the third quarter, 40-13, the game has turned from a tight one as they answered back and forth, swapping touchdowns, to a blowout. And here's a slot screen over on this side, and Smith, good coverage, nothing there. It's kind of what Tennessee Vols do. They throw a quick out pattern and have a couple of receivers blocking, and that time Jackson Christian did not execute properly.
Yeah, Donovan was able to get off his block very quickly and sniff out the play and get right in front of Mosley to kind of rattle him a little bit and get him off his focus.
Right, third down and 11, 51 seconds left. Four-man front rush. Kelly needs to go to the air, and he's back to pass. Pass across the middle, incomplete. Donovan Smith with the coverage, knocking the ball out of the hands of Mosley, who's also had some good catches. Incomplete, fourth and 11. Let's see what Jackson Christian does. There's nothing really to lose here. They might as well go for it, even though they give us a short field. We're going to take it down no matter the length, so they're kind of in that situation. 40-13, 44 seconds to go. So the Eagles' defense remains the same. Kelly needs a big first down pass right here. Got four-man rush. Here they come. He's rolling to the left. He's being pressured by Demumbrium. Turns, tries to get it upfield. He's not going to make it to the 40, to the 43. Steps out of bounds. He'll be about 2 yards short. It will go over to Nashville Christian.
Back to back to back turnover on downs.
Right, it's tough on them. Leaving us a short field to explode one more time. Clock for your third quarter at 32 seconds. As we're bringing the last telecast of the year. And hopefully, if things hold up, we'll be playing one more time in Choo Choo Town. Ball at the 43. Curtis under center. He's got Cam Carden in the back. See if it goes to him. No, he's faking. Back to pass. Looking in the end zone. Throwing the ball long downfield for Smith. It's deflected as they were going after Smith again. He would like to see a flag. They're not going to throw one there. 21 seconds left. Great fake by Curtis and steps up. A ball a tad overthrown. If he could have led him into the end zone, it might have been six.
Mm-hmm.
Covering was Jack Collins. 40-13, the ball comes back to the 43-yard line. Nashville Christian, total control since midway of the second quarter. Into the line. Curtis, this time, back in the gun. Carden on his hip on the right. Goes to Carden. Stutter steps at the line, and they're going to hit him behind the line of scrimmage. Good pursuit and penetration there. And guess who led it? Big Anderson, helped out by a couple of other players. The ball at the 44-yard line. The clock's going to run down. And we're going to take a brief break with your score in the semifinal of the state. Single A, private school division, NCS 40, JCS 13, 12 minutes left, back in a moment. Nashville Christian to the line. Third down and 11. Curtis at the 44-yard line. He's back to pass. Looking, throwing the ball down the middle. It is complete to Warmbrough. Intercepts the 20, 15, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Give him six large ones. Touchdown, NCS. Warmbrough, aerial bullet strike for six.
Let's try to take another 44 look.
44-yard line. He's back
Curtis
to pass.
Curtis throws a rope.
Looking, throwing the ball down the middle.
Center of the
complete to Warmbrough.
Warmbrough
breaks
the tackle.
20,
15, 10, 5, 4, 3.
Toward Charlotte Pike. Excuse me, that was towards Sawyer Brown Road. Wyatt Martin in for the point after. It's 46-13. Ball is placed down. Kick is up, and he's going to split them. Good. Timeout on the field with a score. Nashville Christian, 47. Jackson Christian, 13. First play of the fourth quarter. Back in a moment. Take another look at the play.
He's back to pass.
Great round. On the ball down
throw.
The middle. It is complete to Warmbrough.
And Warmbrough
intercepts the 20,
the
15, 10, 5, 4,
47 to 13.
Back to live action. Any of you players that see Mr. Atkins on Monday, be sure and thank him for the extra technology that's been added tonight. And Wyatt Martin to kick. And Chandler, the mercy rule is rolling, so we're going to be under 10 minutes after this play, so that's going to help a lot. Here's the kick by Martin. Nails it pretty deep. And it's going to be caught back at the 5, 10, 15. Cutting to the middle, 20. Breaks one tackle, 25. And nice run. He's still on his feet, pushing to the 28, and then we shove him back. Do we have a update?
It is tightening up against with USJ against Friendship Christian. Friendship still leading, but now by three. There's just about 6 minutes to go left in the game over there.
All right. So we'll see where we're at the end of this game in relation to that game, because we do play the winner. And the mercy rule is in effect, thank goodness. And I guess they have to stop the clock. We've got, Braylon Toll down. And they do stop the clock for the injury and timeouts and after touchdowns. But other than that, the clock will keep running even on an incomplete pass or out-of-bounds play. So hope Brother's okay. They're helping him off. Looks like Blair Otero will check into the lineup. Now they wind the clock. 47-13. This one's all but over. Kelly would like to mount one last drive for his team. Boyd left side, and he pushes ahead. He's had some good runs tonight. They've had some good plays, just not enough. Robbins, the linebacker spot, brings him down. He's going to pick up only about two. Second down and eight, ball to 30. And we just entered the nine-minute mark. So everybody, student body over here on the right side, see what Kelly does. Now he shifts, gets a tight end back on the left and a flanker to the left. Two wide outs over this side. Back to pass. Looking, waiting, airing it out down the sideline. That pass is intercepted and then caught. Incredible. Jalen Mosley with a nice grab. And we'll take another look at that as the ball gets down to the 38-yard line. We had good
looking,
coverage.
Waiting, airing it
we
out
actually
down
had
the
an
sideline.
Interception
that pass
first.
Is
intercepted
and
then
quite
caught.
Get that into the camera.
Incredible. Jalen Moten, 8:15. Kelly trying to get one last score up for his team. And a quick out pattern here complete. 35, 34, 33 down to the 31.
Oh, Potts is down.
Now Potts is down. That's not good. 47-13, 7:55 to go. He's rolling. There'll be a timeout here. They'll bring Potts off. Boy, he is. He's holding collarbone. His shoulder. Oh, my goodness. 47-13. That's not good. Oh, man.
Yeah, he's pointing at his collarbone.
Ball at the 30-yard line. That's tough. We have a 34-point lead, so hopefully we can get some younger guys in here so we don't lose a starter for the state championship. We're down to 7:20. Second down and 2. And Jackson Christian's Kelly will now ensue the play. And to Boyd, he's trying to turn that corner. Cuts back against the grain. Is not going to get to the first down marker. He's just short, I believe. Woodard on the stop. It's going to be 3rd and 1. 6:45 to go. I think Potts is okay. Jackson Christian, 3rd and 1, desperately needing to keep this drive alive. And to Boyd up the middle. Nice run, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. He's going to go into the end zone. That was a nice run by him right up the gut. And so Jackson Christian does get another score. And we'll take another look at that one as he went straight up the middle and a nice run. And to Boyd up the middle. Nice run, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. He's going to go into the end zone.
Great blocking.
That was a nice run by him.
Christian.
Kelly, the quarterback to hold. Zach Sisko trying to kick it into the creek. 47-19 placement, and he's got it. Splits them 47-20. So still a 4-score game. Chandler, updates.
Friendship Christian pulling away from USJ. They undefeated in the regular season.
Ooh.
They are up 9 with less than 4 to go.
So at this point, barring an incredible comeback by USJ, our opponent will be the Friendship Commanders from Wilson County. And that'll be 2 weeks from yesterday.
I think they are the overall number one seed for our entire division.
All right. So it'll be exciting to be at. Last year, the weather was phenomenal. I hope we can be so fortunate this time. And it's during the day. That helps, too. If you get a sunny day, you can take 30 degrees. 6:22 to go. Nashville Christian. Set to receive. Let's see if Jackson Christian opts for an onside kick. Sisko to tee it up. They have everybody lined up evenly on the kick, but that doesn't mean they won't attempt the onside. Realigns the ball. We've got everybody up tight except one deep man expecting the onside kick. He punches it out to the side. It's going to go out of bounds. We're going to get the ball in good field position.
Interesting note, Friendship Christian played DCA in their first playoff game and won by 1 in overtime, 14-13.
All right. And here is Blair Otero, 40, 45. Nice run that time. I'm sorry, Brock Haywood. I got to quit missing these guys. So a great run. I was checking some other things and looked up and did not catch the right number. Brock Haywood with another nice run out to the 50-yard line.
In their first playoff game.
Take a look at that again.
1-1 in overtime, 14-13.
All right. And here is
Burns the corner.
Blair Otero.
And nice 40, 45. Right
nice run that midfield strike. First down and 50 to go for a first. I mean, for a touchdown. And 5:43 to go. Curtis still in there at quarterback. Gives to Haywood again. He's going to be hit at the line of scrimmage. No gain. Second down and 10. Second down and 10, 5:20 to go. Is the clock winding out here on a great season for Jackson Christian and now an even better season for Nashville Christian as they get to continue theirs in the state championship, looking like Friendship Christian. Curtis, slant pattern, warm bro, complete, 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. What did he do? He scored! Touchdown, Eagles. Whew, nice run after the catch. And let's take another look at it.
Curtis,
slant pattern, warm bro, complete.
Pattern,
40,
and he outruns 35,
30, 25, 20, 15, 10,
it takes
5,
53,
4, 3, 2, 1.
Wow,
what did
that's
he do?
Five
he scored!
Touchdowns for Jared Curtis over the air, and then not to mention the one-yard punch-in he had in the first quarter. So that's six that Jared's responsible for.
Watt Martin kicks it, splits them. So we increase the lead. So this one's about all over, 4:25 to go, and they are running the clock, fortunately, after the touchdown. It's at 54-20. Let's see if we can get some younger guys in there, hopefully. Hate for somebody to get hurt in this situation. Clock at 4 minutes and running, so that's good. It'll be over here in a minute.
I like how this is communicating to Friendship that, you know, hey,
yeah,
you're going to have to put up a bunch of points on us if you want to go toe-to-toe with us.
Exactly. So Nashville Christian sends out the kicking team, Wyatt Martin, to do the honors one more time. 3:45.
Oh, USJ pulled within four. I think they got a field goal. But no, they scored.
Landon Travis is into the game, so Chandler's trying to get a few of these new names coming into the contest. Michael Hoskins is out there on the kickoff team.
We got Aiden Burr.
Aiden Burr over
senior
here.
Senior.
Next to us here.
Got 43 as well, R.J. Perkins.
R.J. Perkins, freshman. So we got some new guys in there. We'll try to pick them up for you. Clock down, approaching 3 minutes. And Wyatt with the kick. Punches it toward the sidelines, and it's going to be caught on the bounce at the 25 to the 30. And nice struggling run up to the 34-yard line.
So number 28 out there as well, Landon Travis, another freshman.
So we'll try to get a few new guys out here.
We got 58. We got Blake Womble out there, another senior.
2:44 to go. And the last drive probably of the year for Jackson Christian. Boyd looked like he got his head pulled back, but no call. Another good run by Boyd, as he's going to carry for about six, making it second and four, pushing the ball to the 41-yard line. 54-20, 2:19 and ticking. Blair Otero picking up receiver nearest the corner, nearest the screen to you. Back to pass. He's going to be hit as he throws, and an outstanding leaping catch. Incredible grab. Guess who? Was it Mosley? It was Mosley. And we'll take another quick look at that. Outstanding throw
the corner
by Kelly. Here's the
with pressure coming.
With pressure. They were right all over him, and he threw a rope. He's going to be hit as he throws, and an outstanding leaping catch. Good coverage. Back to live action at the 38. Kelly giving to Boyd. Cuts against the grain, and the sophomore doesn't get much. Cam Cardin on the hit. 54-20, a minute and a half left in the semifinal game. We haven't had a lot of close games this year since.
Except for the ones we lost.
Yeah, really, except for the Davidson Academy game. After that, we pretty much dominated everybody.
Mosley picks up another first down, it looks like, off a little screen pass.
We've only had one close win. The rest have been blowouts. The closest being 31-7. Against BGA. Third down and one. Back to Boyd. He's got a lot of yardage tonight. Racks up a few more as they try to get down toward the end zone with 48 seconds left. The clock running 54-20 in the semifinals. Jackson Christian with their last hurrah trying to punch one into the end zone. Nice job of no huddle offense as they've taken a nice drive down. Back to pass. Kelly lobbing for the corner, and it's going to be incomplete. Good coverage there. And more than likely, they're only going to get one playoff. Jackson Christian, I don't think they're going to call a timeout. They've got three left. Are they going to let the clock run out on this season? No, they're going to come to the line one last time. 15 seconds to go. Last play of their year. Last play of our game, but not our year. 5 seconds. Kelly will give to Boyd. He's going to try to get outside. Does he get into the end zone? He's going to race down the sideline. And he gets popped. Did he get in?
No.
Did he score?
No.
He did not score. But it was a nice run. Our game. And so
we'll
show you the replay
Five
of
seconds.
That. Kelly, for his family to enjoy.
He really had
try to get
run.
Outside. Does he get into the end zone? He's going to race down
the
sideline. And he gets popped.
So,
Nashville Christian with a great win, winning 54-20 as the teams go to midfield and shake hands. And Chandler? Thank you for a great job of commentating and spotting for me. I can't do this by myself. He points out, which you don't see behind the camera, he's pointing at all the guys that are making the plays at the time, and it helps me out tremendously. So Jalen Boone was on our computer graphics, did a great job. And as always, our producer, Andrew Atkins, setting all this equipment up, and we owe him a great debt of gratitude. Be sure and thank him when you see him, players. And we were able to add the instant replay tonight. And up on top, Colin Sawyer did a great job. And we're going to close it down. And we'll be at the state tournament 2 weeks from yesterday. The final score, Nashville Christian 54, Jackson Christian 20. For the last time this year, this is Mike McPherson for Chandler Clark, saying thank you for your time at this time. Until next time, until basketball season on this, the Nashville Christian Eagle Broadcasting Network.